This video is a tribute to the British actor John Savident. His career in movies and television included more than 130 credited roles during a time span of 70 years. He was selected for a small role in the epic 1970 historical movie Waterloo. Fortunately, he was perfectly cast for the character he portrayed. Savident acted in a convincing portrayal of an important general. The actual historical person was General Carl Ferdinand von Muffling. We'll now watch John Savident and his scenes in the movie Waterloo, followed by a 10-minute conclusion summarizing historical facts and movie fiction relating to those scenes.
That's a Prussian officer.
What's he doing?
That gentleman will spoil the dancing.
It's Napoleon, sir. Yes.
I'm aware, Muffling. Napoleon has crossed the border.
With all his forces, he has come between both our armies.
Where?
At Charleroi.
Charleroi.
Do you wish me to stop the ball, Arthur?
No. I want no alarm. All officers obliged. Ladies will finish the dance. Axbridge, move your cavalry immediately towards Charleroi. Picton, your division will march out tonight.
Blücher on his right should be on his left.
By now, sir. He should have come by Mons, logically.
What could be simpler than so? He's humbugged me. In a night's march, he's made us piecemeal. I must concede he's gained a victory at the cost of boot laces. If Marshal Blücher stays in Belgium, I stay too.
On that promise, Lord Duke, Blücher would tie his men to trees if necessary.
These four roads here.
Quatre Bras, he's bound to go for them, sir.
If we can't hold him there, I'll stop him here. Charleroi. By God, that man does war on her.
Why is he standing there? What is his reason? They lost his caution. There must be something I don't understand.
If only Blücher could outrun Grouchy, give me the help of even one corps.
The Prussians. It all depends on the Prussians.
Why is it Grouchy does only 6 miles a day and I do 10?
The mud on that slope would help us. We must slither up to it. But the roads could slow Blücher, and that'd be the end of it.
Well, tell him the roads are the same for everyone. True? True?
Yes, sire.
Then you tell him to walk faster.
You may fight your battle, Field Marshal. You may fight your battle.
Where is Grouchy and his 30,000 men?
Grouchy is following us, step by step. He's not between us.
What's the time, hey?
I think it's after 2, Your Grace.
It's 10 to 2, sir.
Muffling, I must ask you to go out once more tonight.
Oblige me with a fresh horse, sir.
I beg!
Marshal Blücher to come to Waterloo by 1 o'clock.
Don't you see, Uxbridge? Now if Grouchy turns and comes between us...
And catches a Prussian strung out on the march.
Then it would be just a matter of counting our dead.
With such a risk, dare we rely on Blücher?
We have to rely on each other, Uxbridge. Gentlemen.
And now for a review of John Savident's scenes in Waterloo. A 10-minute overview summarizing the actual historical facts and also the movie fiction relating to those scenes. In 1815, Europe's final war against Napoleon Bonaparte broke out. Napoleon had attacked 2 of the Allied armies stationed next to each other in Belgium. The British Duke of Wellington commanded one of the armies, which was a mix of British, German, Dutch, and Belgian troops. The other army consisted of Prussian soldiers under the command of Field Marshal Blücher. Prussian General Muffling served in the very important role acting as the Prussian army's liaison to the Duke of Wellington. The 3 historical figures were played by actors who looked very similar in appearance to them. John Savident appears during the movie for 3 scenes, acting in his important role very convincingly. The tense scenes are recreated loosely based on the actual historical facts that took place. At dawn on June 15, 1815, Napoleon launched his French army against the armies of Wellington and also the Prussians. The movie correctly presents the French army's invasion into Belgium, threatening to split the 2 Allied armies apart. One important scene recreates Wellington's controversial attendance at a party on the night of the day of the invasion. It is during this festive ballroom scene that Savident makes his first appearance in the movie. He is shown suddenly arriving at the Brussels ball, causing a nervous sensation among the guests, including Wellington, his army officers, and the local social elites. The storyline presents the Prussian general just arriving from the front lines to confirm news of Napoleon's invasion. The scene is well acted, contrasting Savident's restrained anguish with Plummer's cool and calm reaction, which was a trademark of Wellington. Although the scene is good movie drama, much of it deviates from historical facts. The real whereabouts and definite activities of General Muffling on June 15th were made very clear by him in his own memoirs. It should be first pointed out that the movie's depiction of General Muffling busily carrying messages between both army commanders all by himself is false. Muffling articulates clearly in his memoirs that he had under his command a small team of officers and messengers. The general and his staff were each very active during the 4-day Waterloo campaign. The popular myth that invents Muffling unexpectedly arriving at the Brussels ballroom, searching desperately for Wellington, is in stark contrast to the reality explained in his memoirs. General Muffling was in Brussels, in direct contact with Wellington, since the early evening, just after news had reached him by 6 p.m. from the Prussian army's front line, raising the alarm of the French army attacking them in full strength. Muffling was in Wellington's company during the evening when more news arrived at 7 p.m. from Marshal Blücher reporting that the Prussian army was preparing for battle the next day. Wellington then began preparing the first readiness orders for his own army. Unfortunately, the overcautious Duke had earlier countermanded important action orders started by his frontline First Corps commander, the Prince of Orange, and his staff. Muffling retired to his own quarters at 10 p.m. Muffling stated that it was just before midnight when Wellington came to see him, advising him that he received an important report from his own army intelligence officers, which had mostly, but not entirely, dismissed his fears that Napoleon would make a sneak attack towards Brussels from another direction via Mons to hit his own army's center further north along the French border. The movie falsely implies that Wellington gave his first orders to mobilize his army around the time the ball ended. The fact is, he actually issued orders before arriving at the Brussels ball. Just before going to the ball, Wellington had already begun issuing his first movement orders for his army to concentrate at assembly areas in their own various regional locations. Muffling claimed further that when he and Wellington went to the ball together, it was Wellington's reasoning that his presence there would show everyone, and especially pro-Bonapartist Belgians, he was not alarmed by Napoleon's nearby invasion. Even so, the locals in the capital could hear the rumblings of cannon fire coming from the battles on the front line, 30 miles away to the south. Napoleon was near their doorstep. Savident's second scene in the movie has his character attending an ad hoc war council that Wellington had historically summoned just before the ball ended. The war council was initiated by Wellington following word he had promptly received from one of his commanders, the Prince of Orange, that his own army's advanced positions were under attack. Savident uses a very good German accent as the Prussian General Muffling, giving assurances to Wellington of the Prussian army's war readiness. In reality, just before going to the ball together, both Muffling and Wellington already had a discussion in which both affirmed their army's mutual cooperation. The ball finishes with an anticlimax as nervous officers rush to join their alerted units. Wellington had intended to get a brief rest at his own quarters. Upon arriving at his home, the Duke was stunned by news of an important earlier report that had failed to reach him promptly. The news confirmed there were no threats of a second invasion on the Belgian border. Napoleon's early morning attack was no feint. Wellington immediately joined Muffling and both followed the Allied army marching south to war. Later that day, Wellington with half of his army had defeated the portion of the French army led by Marshal Ney that had earlier attacked his own sector at the Battle of Quatre Bras. Meanwhile, Napoleon led the rest of his army in the attack and defeat of the Prussian army at Ligne, 8 miles away. To avoid being trapped by Napoleon, Wellington ordered his own army to retreat back towards Brussels. Savident's third and final scene is a blend of his first two scenes. He again makes a dramatic entrance, delivering once more an urgent message for Wellington, who is having a war council with his staff. Historically, this scene is taking place the night before the Battle of Waterloo. Wellington's army has halted after a day of retreat. Overnight, Wellington and his staff prepare the next day's battle plans. General Muffling was in fact entirely present in the overnight war council. He did not arrive in the middle of the meeting, as the movie incorrectly portrays. He was also crucial in creating the strategy for the final battle planning, involving how the Prussian army would arrive and join the battle. Hours earlier, Wellington had received news from the Prussians confirming that most of their army was moving to join his own army for the next day's battle. At 2 a.m., the time of the movie scene's recreation of the meeting, more news arrived confirming the Prussians would specifically come with three army corps, not just one, as the movie implied. The movie's central narrative for the battle is very deceptive. It conveys Wellington with a mostly British army doing all the fighting at the battle, and the Prussian army appearing only at its end. The same myth that Wellington himself promoted. The total number of soldiers in both Allied armies fighting the French at Waterloo was around 130,000 men. And of that total, about 22,000 were British. Most of the rest were German-speaking. Only a few short scenes show Prussian troops simply marching, galloping, or retreating. Unfortunately, the movie missed out on using Savident as Muffling in further well-acted appearances, which, if facts were used, would have made the film more historically accurate. By ignoring using John Savident as General Muffling during the Battle of Waterloo scenes, the movie writers and director, Sergei Bondarchuk, missed a golden opportunity to diminish the all-too-obvious pro-British bias which would have balance the movie by correctly representing the Prussian army's real presence at Waterloo.